Hans Clodhopper. A long time ago, in a far-off land, there lived a king and his daughter. One day, the princess complained to her father, "Papa, your majesty, I can't find a single boy in the entire land with whom to have an intelligent conversation." The king immediately put out a proclamation. Hear ye, people of the land. Whichever boy can have an intelligent conversation with my daughter, the princess, he shall have half of my kingdom. He shall one day be a prince and maybe even a king." All of the boys soon heard about the king's offer. They began reading every book, every newspaper, even the laws of the land, searching for fancy words, for they had heard that the princess was very, very smart. Now in this land lived a family way out in the country. There was a father, a mother, and three brothers. One of the brothers was called Hans Clodhopper. He was always tripping over his great big feet. He had a big coat with huge pockets that were always filled with things he found. There was always something in his pockets, like birds' eggs, feathers, bugs, and whatever else he picked up in the woods. The three brothers heard about the king's proclamation. Two began to read and study fancy words. Hans Clodhopper stayed out in the woods all the time. And finally, one day, the two brothers came to their father and told him they were ready to go and have a conversation with the princess. Their father told him to take his best horses, and off they rode to the palace. They hadn't gone far when Hans Clodhopper came out of the bushes. "Hey, where are you guys going?" The brothers told him they were going to talk with the princess.
"Hey, I'm going with you guys. I'm a good talker, too."
His brothers just rode off, hoping Hans would leave them alone. Hans Clodhopper ran into the house.
"Hey, Dad, I need a horse, too. I'm going to go talk to the princess."
His father said, "You can't have a horse. Besides, you're not smart enough to talk to the princess." Hans Clodhopper replied,
"Oh, yes, I am."
He ran out into the farmyard and caught his billy goat. He grabbed onto the horns and jumped onto its back. He bounced wildly along after his brothers. When they saw him coming, they cried out,
"Oh, no."
Together, the three brothers rode along the old country road. They hadn't gone far when Hans Clodhopper got off the goat and reported,
"Hey, look what I found. It's an old dead crow."
His brothers frowned. "What are you going to do with that?" Hans smiled.
"I'm going to give it to the princess for a present."
He put it into one of his coat buckets, and his brothers cried out,
"Oh, no."
As the three brothers rode along together, Hans Clodhopper got off the goat again.
"Hey, look what I found. It's an old broken shoe."
His brothers wanted to know, "Are you going to give that to the princess, too?" All Hans could say was,
"Yeah."
He put that into his pocket as well, and his brothers cried out,
"Oh, no."
Soon they came to a huge mud puddle in the road. The two brothers on the fine horses rode around the puddle. Hans Clodhopper got off the goat. He took off his shoes. Then he began to walk out into the mud, squishing it between his toes, saying,
"Oh, man, this is the best mud I've ever seen."
Then he picked up huge handfuls and squished it between his fingers. Much to the dismay of his brothers, he began to put handfuls of the mud into his pockets. They cried out,
"Oh, no."
Soon the three brothers arrived at the palace. There was a long line of boys all trying to have a conversation with the princess. Inside the palace, the princess sat on a throne in a long room with mirrors on the ceiling. On both sides of her stood the ladies in waiting, all wearing fancy gowns. The guards in their fancy uniforms stood at attention. In the back of the room were all of the town's nobles. They were writing down all the things the boys said in order to publish them in the newspapers. This way, everyone could read about it. The king was there, too. He was sitting by the fireplace, roasting chickens on a spit. One by one, the boys would come in, and one by one, the guards threw them out. None had been able to have a conversation with the princess. Finally, the three brothers got their turn. The oldest came in and stood before the princess.
"Good day, your majesty."
And she in turn replied,
"Good day to you."
The brother then wiped his brow and reported, "It's quite hot here in your palace." The princess told him, "That's because my father's roasting chickens." The boy just stood there. He didn't know what else to say. The guards took him away. A second brother came in. He too addressed the princess.
"Good day, your majesty."
And she in turn replied,
"Good day to you."
The brother took off his hat and reported, "It's quite hot here in your palace." The princess told him, "Well, that's because my father is roasting chickens." The boy just stood there. He didn't know what to say. And the guards took him away. Finally, Hans Clodhopper got his turn. He didn't walk into the palace. He rode the goat. When he looked up at the ceiling, he exclaimed, "Hey, I'm upside down." He bounced on the goat right up to the front of the throne room, smiling and waving, "Hi, princess, how you doing?" The princess couldn't help but smile back and replied, "I'm just fine, thanks." Then Hans Clodhopper took off his hat and wiped his brow, saying, "It sure is hot here in your palace." And as she had told the others, she let him know, too, that, "Well, that's because my father's roasting chickens." Hans took the old crow out of his pocket and wondered, "Hey, maybe we can cook this old crow." The princess replied, "Well, we don't have a pot." Hans reached into a pocket. "Well, we can use this old shoe." The princess chimed in, "Well, we don't have any gravy." Hans Clodhopper knew better. "Oh, yes, we do." He took out two big handfuls of drippy, gooey mud. The guards gave him a dirty look. The ladies in waiting stuck their noses up in the air, and Hans cried out, "Hey, don't look at me like that." And he began to throw mud at everyone. The princess jumped up from the throne and ran over to him. "Will you show me how to do that?" Soon they were laughing together and throwing mud at all the ladies and guards. The king couldn't believe his eyes. They began to talk nonstop. They talked about everything under the sun. They became best friends. The king lived up to his promise and gave the boy half of his kingdom. He was made prince, and one day he became the great King Clodhopper.